What about if someone calls the police because your adult child is acting strange in public? What about if you are driving and your child decides to leave the car when the police arrives? Or perhaps your nonverbal adult child is in the passenger seat and have a huge meltdown because they don't know what's going on and they're unable to follow instructions. That is always on my mind. We're talking about seconds here, life and death scenarios, and it is extremely concerning that any of us, any of our children can be in these kind of situations. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I hope you're doing great. Today I wanted to make a video about something that has been on my mind a lot since the horrific killings of George Floyd as well as Elijah McClain. And you know, when watching these videos, I couldn't stop thinking about my own children and their position of vulnerability due to autism in these kind of situations. And I am very sure you have been thinking the same thing. What about if someone calls the police because your adult child is acting strange in public? What about if you are driving and your child decides to leave the car when the police arrives? Or perhaps your nonverbal adult child is in the passenger seat and they have a huge meltdown because they don't know what's going on and they're unable to follow instructions. That is always on my mind. We're talking about seconds here, life and death scenarios, and it is extremely concerning that any of us, any of our children can be in these kind of situations. And I'm sure you have been thinking about this a lot. So what do we do? You know, even though we cannot have complete control over everything in life, really, I believe that there are key steps that we can take. For example, we can register our children at our local police station as well as fire stations and hospitals. Because depending on where you live, there is usually a registry of people with disabilities. So basically, the police will take your name, your address, your child's information, details about their behavior. So the police will know how to interact with your child in case of an emergency or a traffic stop, for example. You can even add, I don't know if you saw them, some of those stickers outside your door or window that states someone with autism live here. And you know what? Don't be shy. You can also send autism information to your local police department so they will know what to expect. Because we have to be very honest here. We cannot assume that police officers are trained to handle this type of situations because we know it is not always the case. So if we can provide as much as information as possible, that would be great, especially detailed information about our own kids. For example, why trying to touch or restrain your child in any manner can make things worse. So why it is not a good idea to ask them too many questions or give plenty instructions at once. You can also take the opportunity to arrange for the cops that patrol your neighborhood to meet with you so they can familiarize themselves with your child and your family. So basically, trying to help the situation and the community as well, because they don't know much about autism. Another thing you can do is to ensure your child has at all times a card that can be placed around their necks, a wallet or ID or pocket where it states that they have autism. And if they seem nervous, anxious, or they might not respond, it's due to their condition and not due to them being uncooperative. This is a very important card for them to have. So when they provide their ID or they are searched, the officer can also read this card and put things into perspective. Last but not least, role play. Especially safety precautions with your child. Explain why you're doing it and place them in a specific scenarios and teach them what the appropriate response should be. And don't just do it once and expect they will remember. No, do it often so the information is always fresh in their mind. I know it is scary. I know. And it is difficult to discuss these things, but the reality is that our children will only get older, not younger. We live in dangerous times, and with autism in the mix, we need to be very proactive to ensure their safety at all times. Remember, we are in this together. You are not doing it alone, and we are all here to support each other. We got this.